Hey, what's up, guys? It's Knights Templar here. Welcome to round 13.2, USSR. Quite a few things are happening on the Eastern Front here. Germany has made its way deeper into Soviet territory, so they're doing a fine job, I must say. It looks like the USSR and Japan are going to war this turn. I have declared war on Japan, so that should be interesting. Thought it'd be something that the Russians needed to do. So nonetheless, before I actually get into my turn, I have to do the recruitment roll for the Vichy French. So let's go ahead and do that. I do need to get a 2 or less, and he did decide that he will want an infantry in southern France. So that is a 7, so that is a miss. Okay. So starting my turn, I have $57 to, well, 57 technically IPP. This turn, since I did declare war on Japan, this $5 has to go to the bank. So, and then I'll have $52 to spend. So what we're going to purchase is we're going to purchase 7 infantry, 4 anti-aircraft guns, and we're going to upgrade 2 infantry to 2 motorized, and then we're going to start a construction on a fortification, and then we're going to do 4 militia. So first things first, that's that glare. There we go. You got 4 techs. We're going to go for strategic rockets, proof construction, long-range aircraft, and advanced mechanized. I've been wanting long-range aircraft for a while now, so hopefully we can have a success on that. So let's go ahead and roll for the techs. So it looks like I got long-range aircraft and I got advanced mechanized. So let's go to let's go to the chart over here. Okay, so long-range aircraft is done. And then advanced mechanized will go up to stage 3. I don't think I have this updated. I'll update it after this, but yeah, had to spend the last few days with family, so haven't had time to record my turn. So okay, so there is quite a few combat moves this turn. Oh, before I start the combat, we are purchasing a mount infantry for the CCP. Forgot about that. Oops. So for combat moves, we're going to start with Japan over here. This sub is going to convoy raid C-Zone 38, and it's looks like it's for 5 IPP, potentially. I do get a +2 with the convoy raid for submarine, so that's one combat here. So I'll just put a little marker here just indicating that I am convoy raiding this zone here. And then the CCP, what we're going to do is these 3 infantry here from Shanghai, and the 10 mountain and the cavalry will invade Suyan. Just want to make sure I'm doing that right. Okay, so yeah, this cavalry will move into this territory as well against a militia and a fighter in Suyan. And then 3 infantry from Cheetah is going to move, yeah, from Cheetah to Western Manchuria. That's where that's going to go. And then
here in northern Manchuria,
we're going to send the rest of these units. So it's a motorized 2 infantry and a cavalry is what we're doing here. So that is the combat move for that part. Let me double check the other combat moves that we have over here in the Middle East here. We're all going to move into Iraq with this cavalry from southern Iran, these four infantry from Azerbaijan, and this motorized as well is going into Iraq from these two territories into here, fighting a single cavalry there. So that's another combat that we're doing. And then we are going to convoy raid the Swedish line here. I messed up. I rolled only one for one sub last turn. I was supposed to roll for three, but we figured that out. Global War 36 Enthusiast did the generated PB dice roll for that, so it doesn't matter. We only got two. We only knocked off two anyway, so it doesn't really matter. But I will roll for all three if the third is necessary. But yeah, it looks like that is all the, let's see. Yeah, all the combat moves that we're doing. So yeah, let's get into it and then we'll get into non-combat. We'll start with the sub over here in C-Zone 38. So, let me, you know what? We're going to do this over here. We're just going to do it right here. The red is the attacker, or sorry, the black is the attacker. The red is the defender. So, let's see here. Okay, so looks like no damage at all. So that gets plus two. It's a six. Yeah, we do no damage to that line with the Russians. So that's unsuccessful. Let's do the three subs in C zone 14 on the Swedish line there. So again, black is the attacker, red is the defender. So for the first submarine, nothing on the first one. Second submarine, nothing on that one again. So, and then the last sub. So that's an 8, 5. That is 3 damage right there. So I get plus 2 for the sub. I'm sorry, this is the defender. So I will only get 1 damage being done to that line with the 3 subs. That is that sucks. So yeah, that's pretty bad. I'm not gonna lie. Only 1 IPP was knocked off on that. So that will take care of the convoy rating. Let's get into the Sulian here with the 10 mountain, the 3 infantry, and the cavalry. So mountain infantry does not suffer the mountain terrain. So I do get 2 or lesses with them. So let me get 10 dice here. Okay. So hopefully we can get at least 2 hits out of these. So here we go. So it looks like we did get 2 hits with the mountain. So 2 out of 10. Actually, it was, holy crap, I'm blind. 4 hits, that's good enough. Okay. The defending units in Suyan is a militia at a 2. That's a miss. And then a fighter at a 6. And that missed. Okay. So this territory here falls to the CCP. So I'll just flip this little marker here. There we go. And this plane is gone, as well as this militia. Okay. And then these are all into this territory. Okay. So that will actually move the CCP, since it is worth 1, they will go to 3 IPP. And then I'll do what we have to spend for them next turn. So, but that is worth 1 IPP added to the CCP income. And then let's go ahead and do the Northern Manchuria. Let me make sure. I do get a -1 crossing a mountain border. So for the first round, so it'll be 3 at 1 and 1 at 2. So I think that's what we got here. So 3 at 1 and 1 at 2 is what we have. And then they have a defending militia there, defending at a 2. So let's go ahead and roll. You know what? Let me get a different color die and we'll roll for the cavalry. So we got 3 1s and 1 2. So we got 2 hits, so that's good enough. The militia will defend at a 2, and it got a 6. So Northern Manchuria falls. Oh, let me get this out of the way to the Russians. So let me take that off. And they go up to a dollar, or go up a dollar. Panzer J, or we noted that I am at 39 this turn, so this will go up to 40 for this territory. And then we're attacking Western Manchuria. I don't get any penalties for attacking that territory, so I will have 3 2s. Hopefully we can get a hit, and we did get a hit, so 1's all we need, and it was good enough. So that militia will fire back at a 2 or less. That's a 10, so I mean it was like 7 and 10, so it's a miss anyway. If they want me to reroll that, that's fine. But Western Manchuria does fall to the Russians, so that is actually another dollar. So I'm at 41. Okay. So that's where we're at with them. So we are, I think that, is, oh, we do have 1 more combat, and that is in Iraq. So that is the 4 infantry, the cavalry, and the motorized. I do get penalized for going into desert. So the motorized will attack at a 1, but if I roll a 12, it has to retreat. Then I have 4 at 1, 4 infantry at 1, and then 1 at 2. So I'm going to roll the motorized separately, and then we'll move on to the 4 infantry and then the cavalry. So motorized at 1. That is a 3, so that misses. And then we have 4 1s and a 2. We're just going to roll these at the same time. So we did get a hit with the infantry. That, like I said, that's enough to take that territory back. And then Iraq, the cavalry does get a defense at a 2. And it got a 3, so that missed. Okay. So Iraq falls back to the Russians. And take that off. Okay. And then, all right, put that back. Russian roundel there. And then I'll go over all the units that are placed in each territory that I do the non-combat and the attack. So I think, honestly, that is it for all the attack moves, combat moves this turn. We're pretty excited. Like I said, glad that we didn't get any hits this turn. We need to do non-combat, which, let's see, I do have quite a bit of. So, I was thinking what I should do is I'll have to double check on this, but I do want to Scorch Earth this turn. I do want to destroy all the rail in southern Belarusia, Smolensk, eastern Ukraine, Donetsk, Kuban, and Komitskaya. As I do want to try to destroy all the rail in those territories. So if I'm able to do that this turn, then that's exactly what I'll do. But like I said, after this turn's over, we'll make sure we double check to make sure that's fine. And because I don't want to be wrong and then have to, you know, explain that it was wrong. So I do want to target those territories for Scorched Earth to destroy the rail there. So that, I think that is it for all the combat phase here. And then we're going to go into non-combat. We have quite a few non-combat moves. So anyway, let's go to non-combat. Okay. So we're going to move one militia and eight infantry from Stalingrad into Don March here. Okay. So these four infantry have not moved. So I'm just going to put them up here. The air transport's going to pick up this airborne unit. And we're going to go to from Stalingrad, and we're going to land in Leningrad. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. So got enough to make it. I'm going to have to put a one of those coaster. I don't have any task markers, so I'm going to have to use a coaster for this Leningrad territory afterwards. One militia from Saratov to Don Manich, whatever, Marnich, whatever you want to call it. Here, you know what? Let me just chip this up as I'm going. It's just easier for me to remember what we're doing here. So that's what we got there. What else? We're going to take four militia and six infantry from Moscow to Western Russia. So the six infantry from Moscow to Western Russia and the four militia. I don't know why that's there, but whatever. Two Katyusha rockets move from Moscow to Leningrad, so that can reach. You know what? Let me get a coaster real quick, and then I'm just gonna put them all on the coaster as I'm going. So if I have any more Russian coasters. I think I do. I'm not sure. You know what? Let's just use this here. So there we go. I'll put it on after I move everything, but I'm gonna use this to mark Leningrad. All right. We're going to move 4 motorized infantry and 4 advanced artillery from Western Russia to Leningrad. So I'll just actually put these. So these are going to Leningrad. And actually, whatever I've moved this turn is what I'm putting on there. So let's just fix that problem real quick. That way I'm not confusing myself. Okay. All right. So we're going to do 3 infantry, 1 artillery, 2 Katyusha rockets, 5 heavy armor, move from Oral-Kursk to Western Russia. So yeah, 5 heavy armor. And that's going to move to Western Russia. So that goes here. Actually, these need to move back. So, and then we have I think what I meant was it's going to be 4 heavy armor. 4 heavy armor goes to Western Russia, not 5. So the artillery and the Katyusha rocket from Oral-Kursk to Western Russia. So that's what we got there. And I think it's 3 infantry as well is going to Western Russia is how we're doing that. 2 heavy armor are going to go to Leningrad from there. So we're just going to put that on that coaster. 1 militia moves from, let me move this, Kola to Karelia. So I'm just going to chip it out real quick while I'm doing this. There, perfect. And then we're going to do 1 medium armor, moves from Kola to Leningrad. So that medium armor will move from Kola, which I can do it in 2 moves. I can reach. Then we're going to do 2 militia from Karelia to Leningrad. So yeah. So actually, it's only going to be 1 here. And 3 in Leningrad. So, okay. And then we're going to do 1 infantry, 1 artillery from Leningrad to Western Russia. So that goes there. So remember, this is an advanced artillery. That's why I'm not moving it. I need to get some different artillery sculpts. Actually, you know what? Let's do that. I got one. There we go. There's our advanced artillery. And then we'll just put that there. And then 1 of these infantry from Leningrad are going to move to Western Russia. Okay. And then we're going to do 2 advanced artillery from Smolensk to Western Russia, as well as the 2 infantry. Oops, knock that militia over. Let's chip out this artillery here. These are just the regular artillery. Okay. And then we're gonna do 1 motorized, 2 light armor from Eastern Ukraine to Western Russia. Yeah, these are all going to Western Russia here. So from Eastern Ukraine, you go 1, 2. So all of this shit here goes to Western Russia. Okay. And then we're going to do 1. Actually, Global War Enthusiasts, I already moved the light cruiser and two destroyers from CISO 11 to 24. I actually texted the guys, because I forgot it last turn, if I could move it to CISO 24 to link up with the UK fleet, and they said that's fine. So that's where that's at. We're going to do a strategic rail movement. This factory from Orel-Kursk is coming into Moscow. And I think that's all I can do if we're moving a major factory is just that one major factory is considered a my total of two rail movements. So I don't think I have any more from there. We're going to go ahead and go into place units. So for Moscow, we're going to do two anti-aircraft. We're going to do four infantry. Two of the militia is going there. Okay. And then I think that's it for Moscow as far as place units. I can't forget the fortification is being constructed in Moscow and will be done next turn. So, and we're gonna do two militia, three infantry, two anti-aircraft artillery in Leningrad. So let's just put these on. Oops. All right. And then the other two militia will go underneath it. That's it. Yeah, the two, just want to make sure. Yeah, it's two militia. Okay. And then I'll move the rest of the units from Leningrad to this coaster here after my turn's done. So actually, you know what, let's just move it now, because I'm going to do a recap in each of the territory and the territories here. So actually this, I need to get another purple chip to notify that this is an advanced artillery. So let me go get that real quick. Okay. Perfect. Okay. And the only thing that I could think of, we are upgrading these two infantry to motorized. So that is what we're doing. So let me just take this out. So we're gonna have a total of three in Western Russia, because we already had one there to begin with when we moved it. Oh, and then the mount infantry will go in Senshi is what we're gonna do. So that mount infantry will go into Senshi. I'll grab a sculpt for that after I'm done here, but I just want to make sure everything's done. So let's do a recap, and then we'll do collect income, and then we're going to roll for wartime economy, and then we're going to do the recruitment roll for the CCP. So sorry about being slow on the non-combat. I just wanted to make sure that I'm doing everything correctly. So I just want to make sure that everything was done fine, what I wanted to do. So So as far as in Sinshi here, we got 5 militia in a mountain. Xinghai, we have a militia. In Suyan, we have 10 mountain infantry, 3 infantry, and a cavalry. And in Western Manchuria, we have 3 infantry. Northern Manchuria, we have 2 infantry, 2 motorized, or 1 motorized and 1 cavalry. And then let's do the Iraq territory. So we got 4 infantry, a cavalry, and a motorized is what we have there. So we did, so real quick, I did not mention the +2 there. So we did start at 39. We went up 2 over here in Manchuria and 2 over here in Iraq. So we're at 43. And then we'll do the bonuses after we do the collect income. But I just wanted to mention that beforehand. Is there anything that I need? No, that's it. Okay. All right. So here in Don Manich, we have 8 infantry and 3 militia. Actually, was I supposed to move these? I think I was supposed to move the 4 infantry. I don't think so. I think those are staying. I believe those are staying. Let me just double check. Yeah, that's. I think that's it. I'll double check my movement with these 4 infantry, but I think they're either going to Moscow or they're staying there. I just want to double check. But so we have 8 infantry plus 4. We got 12 infantry and 3 militia. Over here in Moscow, we have a construction for a fortification, 2 militia, 2 anti-aircraft, 5. No, it should be 4 infantry, not 5, I believe. Yeah, 4 infantry, not 5. Okay. Over here in Western Russia, we have 4 militia. We've got, is that 4, 7, 4, 6, 7, 10. Yeah, we got 10 infantry here in Western Russia. We've got 2 artillery, we got 2 light armor, we got 4 heavy armor, we got 3 motorized, 2 Katyusha rockets, and then 2 advanced artillery. And then in Karelia, we have a militia. And Leningrad, big one. We have quite a few units here, so looks like we have 11 infantry. Is that... 4 militia, I believe that is. No, 5 militia. We have an airborne unit, an air transport, 2 Katyusha rockets. We got 2 regular artillery. We've got 5 motorized. We got 6 advanced. We got 2 AA guns. We have 1 medium armor and 2 heavy armor is what we have in Leningrad. So I'm just going to put that little chip there just to... There we go, just to notify that territory. I think that is it. So let's go to collect income here. So we started at 39 for the turn. Let me just get these out of the way. Yeah, so we started at 39 for the turn. We went up 2 for the 2 Manchurian territories, so 1 each. So we went to 41. Iraq is worth 2, so 43. We do get the propaganda bonus income, which is +3 for owning Stalingrad, Leningrad, and Moscow. So that is 46. And then the Soviet Arctic convoy, which Madman Dan will allow, which is 48, and then we need to roll for the wartime economy for the USSR, and then the CCP, well, they took 1 from Suyan, They get the bonus for being adjacent to a Russian territory. So they'll have 5 IPP next turn to spend. So right now we're at 48 with the Russians, and we need to do the wartime economy. So let's go ahead and roll for that. So 2-6 sided die. So that's 6 IPP. So that is 54 next turn that I can spend with the Russians. So CCP will have 5. The Russians will have 54 is what we'll have to spend next turn. So pretty long turn. Like, again, I apologize for the slow non-combat moves. Just want to make sure everything was good to go on my end, make sure I did everything correctly. So we need to do the recruitment roll, and then we'll kick it off to Japan. So since we did take another territory, we do have 4 territories now, so we can roll a 4 to hopefully get another infantry. And that's an 11. That's a miss. So our luck ran out from there. So other than that, not a whole lot else for the Russian turn. Only thing else is that I'm going to go ahead and kick it off to Bruce for Japan 13.3 and see how he wants to respond to my declaration of war. Like I said, Bruce, he's done a very, very good job this game. So like I said, I won't underestimate him. So we'll see what he wants to do next turn. So we'll see you for 14.2 next turn. Thanks.